sipping on sky, sipping waterfalls. My youth is yours. Be my woman, girl.
Be your man. I'm gonna share with you guys a few tips on how to live a relatively healthier lifestyle. And I'm sorry if you could hear the jackhammering happening right outside my window. I can't stop it, but I would if I could. But before we get started, I just want to put it out there that I am in no way claiming to be a fitness guru or a health instructor. These are just little things that I've been doing to, again, live a healthier lifestyle. So without further ado, let's get started. So my first tip for you guys is to drink water. And I know what you're thinking. You're like, oh my gosh, Shadina, how original. Drink water. Everybody knows that. But hear me out, okay? Because a lot of us go about our day without realizing that we've not drunk a glass of water in maybe hours and hours, and plot twist, we're already kind of dehydrated. So sometimes when you feel that craving or that hunger, or you're just bored and you want to eat, you can just drink a glass of water, and most likely that will take the desire to eat away. But if you're really hungry, don't not eat, okay? That's just as bad as not drinking water the whole day. So tip number two is to go the extra mile. Me personally, I have so much things that I bring around the house. I have my planner, my notebook, my laptop charger, my laptop. Sometimes I have my camera and my camera charger. Basically, I have so much stuff. And I have to bring everything with me. So instead of forcing everything to go into my hands and possibly dropping everything and breaking my laptop, I take my laptop, I bring it downstairs, then go back, I take my planner, bring it downstairs, charger downstairs, and do that again and again and again and again, and again until I'm tired and my heart is pumping real fast and I'm breathing real hard, which will make me drink more water. And you know, it's a win-win situation. You got exercise and water. Tip number three is to create good eating habits. What I do sometimes if I maybe feel bloated or I want to lose weight is to drink a glass of water before I eat my meal. This results in me eating a lot less because I am filled with water. Also, I would encourage us, because I'm talking to myself as well, to eat slowly, because it takes quite a while for our brain to conclude that we are done eating or that we're full. So when you eat really fast, you don't actually notice that you're already full, but you already gobbled up everything that's on your plate. But when you eat slowly, it gives your brain time to kind of process, okay, I think I'm getting full now. And of course, it doesn't clog up any of your tubes and it helps with your digestion. Tip number dosey-dosey, go for less sugar. Most days I like to eat oatmeal, and I'm gonna be honest with you guys, you know my addiction to bread and jam, and I kinda gained a lot of weight the month that I discovered bread and jam. A lot. And that also goes for breakfast cereal. You don't notice how much sugar and carbs there are in one bowl of cereal until you check the weighing scale after, and it's just not good news, you know? So that's why I've been trying to stay away from bread and jam and cereal and everything unhealthy. Oatmeal helps your digestion and it has fibers that boost your metabolism. Basically, oatmeal makes me poo. yeah. TMI, oatmeal makes me poo a lot. And obviously if you poo a lot, you don't gain as much weight. So I guess that might be my secret. I poo. Tip number five. For people whose excuses are that they don't have enough time to go to the gym or to exercise, girl, you cannot use that excuse no more. I just turned into a country girl. I just discovered a 10-minute workout that you can do at home. You can do it in your house clothes, you can do it in gym clothes, you can do it outside or in your room or anywhere. It's just 10 minutes. I actually used to do this years back until I stopped, gained a lot of weight, and now I'm like determined to be fit again. So that is what I'm doing every day. I literally just search on YouTube 10-minute workout, and like hundreds and thousands of videos will pop up right in front of you. There's one for abs and legs and arms, and I'm hoping there's one for double chins because I need that. I do. Real much. But yeah, so now you have no excuse. There's a 10-minute workout online. Don't tell me you don't have Wi-Fi, because you're watching me right now, so you can't use that excuse either. Go! Let's all do it and save it together! Tip number five. Plus one, find something that you enjoy that helps you stay fit. Generally, I don't like exercising. Sit-ups aren't my thing. They're just people who love going to the gym. I'm not one of those people. So I would encourage you guys to find something else. So I've tried boxing, and even longboarding and skateboarding helps you stay fit. Right now, I have been enjoying biking. That really makes your thighs burn, girl. They burn. Some of you might enjoy swimming or rock climbing or even Zumba. The idea is just to find something that you love that will help you stay fit. So if you guys have any cool activities that you want to share, leave them down below because I'd like to know. I want to try something new too. Tip number 7. Go homemade instead of store-bought. Because when you go homemade, you know exactly what is in the thing that you are eating. Not like when you go to McDonald's and you get fries and you don't even know if it's real potatoes or not. Or like chicken nuggets, there's that pink thing now, and KFC there's the blue thing, and I don't even know what these things are. I'm just waiting for the rainbow thing to kill us all. So I'm gonna teach you guys two of my favorite snacks that I actually make myself at home. The first one is a healthy alternative to ice cream. Roll Betamax. So I have decided to call these smoothie pops. I'm using strawberries and bananas, but of course you can use whatever fruit you'd like. You can totally use a regular blender for this, but I'm just using my NutriBullet. Starting with freshly washed strawberries, I'm just going to cut off the leaves and the leftover stem. I prepared about 10 of these and proceeded to the bananas. I just sliced 2 bananas and put them into my blender. I also added the strawberries into there. And just to make sure that everything blends well, I added some water. This part is pretty self-explanatory. I just blended and distributed that throughout my popsicle containers. And if you were wondering, I got my containers from True Value, but you can also find ones very similar to this in Daiso. So if you really, really, really cannot resist eating chips, and I admit, I feel that way a lot, I will teach you guys how to make homemade potato chips. I'm not saying that this is healthy. I'm saying that this is a healthier version than the ones that you buy at the grocery store or 7-Eleven and things like that. So let's head over to the kitchen. This recipe will be featuring this neat gadget from True Value. This makes slicing potatoes so much easier. When you are done slicing all of that, heat up your pan and fill that with oil just enough to submerge a chip. Then just start placing your raw chips onto the pan. When you see the edges turning into this golden brown, that means it's time to flip it over. When you are done, squeeze out the oil as much as you can. Sometimes I even put it in a strainer just so that all of the excess oil goes away. Now it's time to season it whichever way you'd like, but I just go with salt. So these are just some of the tips I wanted to share with you guys. If you guys have any tips to share as well, leave them down below because I'd really love to know. I'm so committed to staying healthy this year, and I hope this video got you committed as well. A lot of people think that when I'm trying to stay healthy or staying away from chocolates and chips like that, that I'm trying to lose weight, but that's not always the case. I'm not doing this for more likes or more subscribers or to get approval from people. I'm just doing this for myself. I really want to take care of my body because I want to live long and healthy, because there's so many things that I want to accomplish in this life. So I just want to encourage you guys, because I really think you owe it to yourselves to do the same. So I will see you guys later, and may the wings of your eyeliner always be even. Bye!